Hey there, Sharon Reynolds here. Welcome to What's She Up To Now, Day 2010. Documenting the journey originally as I transitioned in 2017, 18, from the brick and mortar corporate world of businesses to the online world of business. I was following my divorce and following divestiture of all the mutual assets we had together, my ex-husband and I wanted to do something, but I wasn't sure what it is. So I've been curious about the internet. I thought I'm going to go on the internet and see what it's all about and see if I want to do that or if I'm going to change my mind and do something different. Because sometimes I like to go down a road and see if it's right for me, which is part of what we're talking about today with putting your heart into something. And this year's annual challenge, the Get Your Goals Annual Challenge, we're focusing on relationships this month. So we are using and applying the last 7 days of each month. We're taking our most important goal, and we just decided that like last month, which is kind of silly, but our most important relationship goal right now, and we're applying the 7-step process to it. First step, current desired situation. What is it? Identify it so we can identify the gap between where we are and what we want with respect to our goal. Today, step two of the relationship goal process is to apply and set it up using the SMART framework: specific, measurable, achievable, relevant, and time-bound. Why? Because if we have a specific, easily measurable goal, we can know if we're making progress toward it or not. And that's really important in all of our goals, but some areas are easier than others to do this too. So whenever it's a challenge to measure something, you might notice I rate and do things on a scale of 1 to 10 a lot, because it takes some of the subjectivity out of what I'm measuring and makes it a little bit more objective, so I can actually look at, well, if I was a 3 yesterday, a month ago, and now I'm a 4, I'm making progress. I'm moving toward what I want. Assuming that 0 and 1 are bad, 10 is good in whatever it is that I'm measuring. So for the SMART goal this month, I'm using the relationship with my granddaughters. Well, that's a pretty broad statement and not a very specific goal. So as I make it specific, it's specific with respect to I want to spend quality time with each and every one of my granddaughters, not just time watching them or babysitting or hanging out, but quality time. And I have to define that for myself and with them. Quality time to me means I'm spending time where we're both enjoying one another's company and we're benefiting from it, and we're doing things that are important and that we both like to do, or that especially that the kids like to do, not just what I would like to do. But there's lots of other factors that come into that. So I applied the SMART framework to that. I shared mine in the challenge today and talked about, for Supersize Your Business, the idiom today is to put your heart into something. And I shared, of course, one of my favorite decision-making, problem-solving tools, or how to make decisions and choose among alternatives, the head, heart, and intuition one, and a couple of stories around why I think that's an important tool to use and have. And I guess I could have shared some detailed examples of businesses that I've been involved in that were awesome businesses but didn't feel right for me. They actually broke my heart. I mean, some of the real estate work that we did was just, it was helping people, of course, but it just still was heartbreaking for me. It's why I could never be a shrink or a counselor or a psychologist or psychiatrist, whichever one's what, because I couldn't hear people's stories and not empathize to the point of almost sympathy. So I know I have to shield my heart and shield my emotions sometimes, so that I don't react in ways that I don't think are appropriate or that for the situation, or that I want to react, right? I don't want to lose my cool. I don't want to yell. I don't want to get mad. I don't want to get upset, angry, feel bad, doubtful, worried, or scared. Who wants to feel those ways? I don't. So if there's ever a business nowadays that I feel that way in, I just exercise my right to choose something different, and I do that. So then I also talked about how important it is, and it's not critical. It's not essential. You can be involved in businesses that you don't like just for the sake of creating some money and resources. I say the reason you create those money and resources in a business that you're good at that you don't necessarily love is to have resources to get involved in a business that you actually love and that you're passionate about. It's really easy to make it through the highs and lows of business if we've got a big reason why and if we're passionate about serving the people that we're here to serve and that we're working with. It's really hard to show up every day to the best of your ability when there are things that don't match your core values, when things that happen in that industry feel off, bad, or wrong, or immoral, or unethical to you. At least that's my definition. And have I stumbled into some of those businesses? No, it does, makes it sound like I don't go into businesses intentionally, and that's absolutely positively not true. I do my homework. I do my due diligence. I make sure that I know what I'm getting into. But it's just like taking a job. You really don't know what it's going to be like and if it's a great fit for you until you get in there and work and understand the culture and the environment. You don't know. And so that happened to me in some corporate jobs where, you know, you think you're getting into one culture because that's what they're selling you on in the interview. And pretty quickly you learn to see through that in the interview and find ways to get that information before you take a job or a role or partner up with that particular organization. So that's it. Wednesday, midweek, always busy in the summertime. We had a big thunderstorm this morning, and so I don't know. We'll see if it stopped raining enough for me to go for my morning quick walk. Otherwise, I will ride a bike, ride my exercise bike. All right, if I can help you in any way with offline or online business, if you've got a burning question and you've tried to figure out the answer but you don't know what it is or you don't know what to do next, I love to help people realize the next thing they need to do in order to especially grow and build and supersize their business, but also with respect to this year's annual challenge, to any goal in any area or aspect of your life, specifically relationships this month, what do you do next? Because the reason I can offer that up is I know that from personal experience and dealing with literally tens of thousands of people, you always know what to do next. You just don't want to take that leap of faith sometimes without somebody verifying, yes, that's the thing you need to do right now. And so I love to be that resource for people and help you have that epiphany that, oh, I guess I'm talking to you, but I really already know what to do, so why am I wasting my time and not just going out and doing it? All right, have a great day, and I'll, of course, be with you tomorrow. Just here to help and share some of my lessons learned. If you've got a question about any of that, please hit me up because it helps me to know what you want to hear about when I talk. All right. Have a great day, and I'll see you tomorrow. Bye.